Worship the Lord altogether in His name. Let us worship the Lord in His presence. See, if He led to the city, let His presence you'll enjoy. Be at peace with the Lord today. I am at peace with my nation since He brought me here today. I'm at peace with the Lord who has washed my sins away. I'm at peace with my Savior, for He filled my heart with joy. I'm at peace with the Lord today. Come, let us worship the Lord all together here today. Let us worship the Lord in His presence as we pray. He'll be there to receive you, and His presence you'll enjoy. Be at peace with the Lord today. I am at peace with my Maker since He brought me here today. I'm at peace with the Lord who has washed my sins away. I'm at peace with my Savior, for He filled my heart with joy. I'm at peace with the Lord today.
Sound pretty good. Let's take that one more time from the top.
Come, let us worship the Lord here today. Let us worship the Lord in His presence as we pray. He'll be there to receive you, and His presence you'll enjoy. Be at peace with the Lord today. I am at peace with my Maker since He brought me here today. I'm at peace with the Lord who has washed my sins away. I'm at peace with my Savior, for He filled my heart with joy. I am at peace with the Lord today.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Will you may be seated in His presence. I'm going to ask Mr. Deb to come and to share some announcements before we go open to prayer.
Amen.
Mr. Deb, come on.
Yes.
Oh, Gloria's going to speak at the women's breakfast, so make sure you come out for that. Gloria, did you know? No. Now you know, right? In season and out, that's right. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, and for those who use the sound system, we recently removed our speakers from the wall and replaced them with the speakers we were using for stage monitors due to the previous speakers being burned up too loud, being turned up too loud, which resulted in them being blown. Please do not turn sound up past the half mark on board, as it will blow out the speakers we now have. Our board is too powerful for the speakers, and the new speakers cost nearly $2,000. So let's be good stewards with our soundboard, people. Amen. Amen? Okay, I think that covers it. Amen? Thank you, Pastor.
Well, happy Mother's Day. I think a lot of mothers went to breakfast with their children or something, right? But those that are here, we're going to have a blessed time in the Lord. Amen. And a lot of mothers are on trips, or people want to stand and take them other places. But we're two or three are gathered together in His name. He is in our midst. Amen. And remember, we're on the internet. And remember to tell people that we're at www.vtfwc.org. Or if you go to YouTube and just search up VTFWC, you can pull up each one of our services. And Kevin does such a good job of getting those up. I'm talking to somebody about live streaming. We may be live streaming once we get protocol in order in the church, and I know people aren't going to talk back to the pastor. because we don't want to risk that type of thing going out onto the internet. But be praying for us as we move forward. Amen.
Amen.
Say 7,000.
7,000.
7,000.
7,000.
You know what 7,000 is? That's the righteous remnant that God had in Israel. When Elijah ran up to the mountaintop and hid in the cave and cried out, "I am alone, remain faithful." But God said, "No, there are 7,000 who have not bowed their knee to Baal." Now, this is a cloud the size of a man's hand. Look around this church. This is a cloud the size of a man's hand. But we have 7,000 righteous that need to be in church with us. And that's my vision. Well, Pastor, we can't hold 7,000. That'll supply. 7,000. I'm looking for the 7,000 righteous in Sacramento. 7,000. Amen? 7,000 righteous in Sacramento. That's the vision I'm casting right now. 7,000. And I don't usually do numbers. God gave that to me today on the way to church. He said, "Call forth my 7,000. So I'm calling forth the 7,000. Pastor, you're crazy. You haven't gone up over 200 ever. 7,000. With what is impossible with man is possible with God. Amen? Amen. And I'm talking about 7,000 righteous, redeemed, holy prayer warriors. I'm not talking about 7,000 members of somebody else's church looking for a fancier place to go. I'm talking about 7,000 people that are sold out to serve God. And to do His bidding in this city. And to fall on their face before God when His judgment's about to fall. Amen? 7,000. Can you get behind the 7,000 righteous? Can you call them forth in prayer? Can you call them forth? Can you call them forth? He's already shown me three or four places the money's going to come from the facility.
Yeah. Yeah.
7,000. That's His righteous number. I'm putting it out there. I'm not afraid to speak the truth. If God gave it to me, it won't fall to the ground. If it's of me, it's of me. But if it's of God, it won't fall to the ground. And He will cause it to come forth. Amen?
Yes,
hallelujah. Let's stand and go to the Lord in prayer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we come before You now. We just give You all the praise and we give You all the glory. We thank You, Lord, for Your ways, Lord, that You have brought salvation into the world, Lord, through Your Son, Christ Jesus, who was born of a virgin, Mother Mary, Father. Lord, how you chose to bring mankind into the world through Eve, the mother of all, Lord. Lord, we thank you now, Lord, that you redeemed us through women, Lord, through mothers, Lord. And so we ask right now, oh Father, Lord, that you would bless every mother here and every mother in the sound of my voice, every mother represented here, both natural mothers and spiritual mothers. There are some that have no children of their own, yet they're a mother to many, Lord. And so I thank you, Lord, and I give you all the praise, and I ask a special blessing upon our mothers, whether here or away at this time. We ask that you would have your way in Jesus' name. Lord, let our anointing flow in our service. Let our worship be acceptable unto you. Let us be pleasing in your sight. Those that are on the way, Lord, bring here safe without any type of trouble, Lord. And Lord, we call forth the 7,000 righteous in Sacramento. We call them forth in Jesus' name. And we thank you, Lord. And we give you all the praise. And we give you all the glory. And we thank you in Jesus' mighty name. And all God's people said, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Give God some glory. Hallelujah. We love the Lord. Hallelujah. We give you glory, Lord. You're worthy of praise. Hallelujah. Worthy of praise. Let's go to the Lord and some praise.
Jesus.
We're going to sing "What a Mighty God We Serve," and feel free to leave your seat and go greet our congregation this morning. Amen.
Glorious time in the Lord. But we had a glorious time in the Lord. That first night we went in, and the and the Spirit was moving and everybody was like soldiers for the Lord. There was a movement there.
When
somebody came in the room, they knew that the women at that place that were gathered together were in spiritual warfare. Well, little did we know, a little did I know, the very next morning my mother got up very, very ill. And she was shaking violently by the time we got to the breakfast. And we had to call 911. And she ended up in the hospital in Monterey. Well, God orchestrated all of that. That hospital there was the most beautiful, magnificent hospital I've ever seen in my life. And I was so thankful for them.
Praise the Lord.
God protected her through the ambulance ride, through everything. That hospital was so thorough that they brought in every kind of specialist and every kind of test that she needs just to find out exactly what caused her problem. Not only cure what brought her in there, but got to the root of everything that was causing her problem. And I'm very thankful for that. And she is home today.
Hallelujah.
Because they wanted her to get stronger after she had pneumonia, a UTI, and then her heart had started stopping for 5 or 6 seconds at different intervals. So they ended up putting a pacemaker in. And so we spent the week in the hospital down in Monterey, but it was the most beautiful place you've ever seen. It was like being in a resort. I couldn't believe it. Tim called it the hospital for the rich and famous of Monterey. But I feel like God was watching over her, but just keep her in a safe place like that and knowing exactly. That's because He knows what we need even before we do. It's everything planned for us. And so this is a very special Mother's Day for me because I do still have my mom. And everybody used to tease me when I was younger and I was having Timothy. We were in Chicago. I wrote her a card and I said, I want my mommy. And so, because I never really grew up in the area, I still want my mommy. God's so good. And so I just wanted to testify to how good God is.
Yes, He is.
So we're going to start this morning by honoring. I don't hope to see too many really young mothers. Maybe some of the rest of the mothers that are in the middle will get a chance this year. Praise God. We're going to start out with our youngest mother. Any mother in their 20s here this morning? About 30s? No mothers back here in their 20s or 30s? I didn't look behind me, so I turn around and make sure. Okay. How about 40s? Mothers in their 40s. Okay. Well, Bobby Joe seems to be the only one. So okay. Which one of the two of you is younger? Maybe you can find out.
Oh, there you go.
Except for your Victory Tabernacle family is a token of our love. They say children are a blessing from the Lord. They're happy as the man whose quiver is full, right? And praise God. And so we thank the Lord for all your mothers, you mothers out there today. Praise God. And the next mother that we want to recognize is the mother who has the most children present with her today. May you stand. Well, see how if you have any children that are here with you today, I need you to stand. Oh yes, sure, Dad. I see them. Barbara does, and Mary Lou does. How many do you have with you today, Barbara?
Jean has one with her.
You have one.
I have one with Mary Lou, how many do you have with you? Two? Okay, we might have a 12. I think we can solve this. Mary Lou, I think that you might be the oldest mother in our midst this morning. So if that's all right, I will honor Sharon with the one with the most. And I'm pretty sure. Let's make sure before I do that. Let's like not have to do something different. Help, Pastor.
Help, Pastor.
Come on, me. I'm not used to tithing. Okay, we have any mothers in their 80s? 80s and above.
Mothers in their 80s.
And that would be Mary Lou, right? Mary Lou, when you come forward, I would like to present you with this one. God's reputation. An unbeliever who steals, deceives, lies, perjures, and swindles is unremarkable. But when a believer acts that way, he disgraces the faith and gives opportunity for unbelievers to say, "You see, he's just like us. I knew there was no substance to his God or his religion." The sages understood the commandment, "You shall not oppress your neighbor nor rob him," Leviticus 19:13, to be a prohibition against dishonest business transactions. As disciples of Yeshua, obedient to God's Torah, we need to strive for scrupulous honesty, especially in matters of business.
Amen. Okay, Brother Kevin, did you find that clip we were talking about? I wanted to show you ladies a little bit about something that... In fact, if you look at my posts, it would be the one my brother actually posted on it and said something about the way to preach, Mama, you sound like Dad more and more every day. We were blessed to go to Monterey. One of our prayer requests we don't have on the bulletin this week is for Shirley Hackney. Shirley Hackney, many of you remember Marissa, she sang on many of the tees, her daughter. Shirley Hackney and her husband Rick were my singles pastors at Trinity Life Center, and Rick was very close to my father. Shirley was diagnosed with breast cancer a while back, and you know what, God always uses her to minister. Do you know she was in the same spa, cancer spa, as a famous, I won't even say who, but it was a famous vocal artist that just passed away from cancer. And she got to minister, lead him to the Lord before he passed away. Yeah, I mean, a very famous person. You'd all know who I was talking about. And God is just so awesome. He used even her illness to take her into a cancer spa where this celebrity who's gone through changes, somebody from England, he just passed away this last year, and she was able to lead him to the Lord before he died. Is that amazing, you know? And then... she has been diagnosed with cancer. It came back. It was in remission. It came back and it's in her lymph nodes. And they're going to go in and remove part of her affected areas. And so she was supposed to have it done while we were there. But she came down with a cold and she had a sore throat and they wouldn't do the surgery. And so keep Shirley Hackney in your prayers while she's there. And I will read the other prayer requests we have. And I'm kind of going out of order, but that's okay. I said, pray for Evan and Emily, that Shlen Vogt and their entire family. They have faced many health challenges, including their 2-year-old son. We all prayed for him when he was bitten by the rattlesnake. Their daughter is having some severe dental issues, and now a crisis pregnancy. And so the doctors keep saying abort. We keep saying life in Jesus' name, amen? Yeah. They've been displaced from their home due to a flood. And they need a miraculous touch on all of these needs, amen? But God is faithful, amen? Pray for my grandma, she continues to get well. Pray for Darlene Brown, even though they're up in Reading. Pray that she recovers from her pneumonia as well. She was diagnosed last Sunday, we found out she had pneumonia. So keep Sister Darlene in your prayers. I pray for Pastor Alma Hawkins. She had a pacemaker that my grandmother did. Inserted. Keep her in your prayers. New Bethel, our sister church. Keep Helen Berlin. I know many of you signed a card. Sharon had a card going around for Helen. So, and a card going around for my grandmother. So if you haven't signed either, they are there. Pray for Helen Berlin. She called also the praise report. Her daughter had gone into the emergency room with some, I don't know how to put it delicately, I'd just say female problems. And they were very concerned. And they called back and said by the time they got in, God had rectified the problem and given the solution. Amen? Praise God. I just want to say that. I keep Lana Corgan in your prayers. Yeah, she just lost her husband, Rob. He went on to glory. Amen? Pray for Joe Barnapesca. For Joe, continue to pray for his lungs. For Margaret, She has excruciating back pain, and she has had blood in her eye. So I don't know the whole story there, but pray that her eye fully heals in Jesus' name. Amen. Keep Marcy DeNiro in your prayer regarding her health issues. God's healing her. Yes, he is. Amen. I see an improvement every day. Pray for me. Pray for me. Do you pray for me? Pray for me. I need all the prayer I can get. I don't even have to tell you why. Just keep praying for me. Pray for Jim Keller. He has started. Remember, he was the one who they said, get your affairs in order. You have 2 weeks to a year to live. He had brain cancer. He had cancer in the lymph nodes. He had cancer in the lungs. He had cancer everywhere. And cancer in the liver. And he said, I'm going to trust God. He went to a prayer meeting. He went back to the doctor. All the cancer was gone everywhere but in his lung. Was it his lung? Yeah, his lung. And so it's shrinking now. It's gone from 9, whatever it was, millimeters or centimeters, down to 5. And they're doing, and so I don't know why God healed everything else instantly and left that one little spot. But you know what? Keep praying. He's asked for prayer that God would miraculously touch him. The word we got from the Lord, I remember Barbara, we called a conference call, and what we heard was the Egyptians you see today, you will see no more. That was the word that God gave. We are believing God for miraculous healing in Jesus' name. Pray for all the missionaries. Pray for the Israel Christian Nexus. Pray for Israel. Pray for the work in Mexico. The Terry and Kenneth are leaving. Pray for the work in Mexico that Don Mager left, but he went to glory. Pray for the works in India that we support. Pray for our church's financial situation to keep going where it needs to go. Pray for the homeless of Sacramento. Pray for all the unsaved loved ones to yield to the drawing of the Holy Spirit. And pray for the 7,000. Amen. The 7,000 are righteous. Amen. The righteous remnant in Sacramento that we're calling forth. Amen. And Kevin, you have that ready? I want to show you just a little bit of what was going on in Monterey. I know some of you were going to go and couldn't go. But they had a mighty move of the Spirit both days. We were only there one day. I'm going to show this to you. Isn't God good? Just wait. Just wait. You know what? I was hit with a wave of discouragement this morning, and that I can rejoice when I get past that wave. Thank you for the one that came and prayed in my office with me, because I know that wave of discouragement always comes when God's getting ready to do something big. Amen? He's getting ready to do something big. Bigger than you can think, ask or imagine. He's getting ready to pour out His Shekinah glory, to pour out His Ruach HaKodesh, to pour out His holiness upon us, amen? And He is a mighty God.
Yes.
Mighty God. Wednesday, for those of you that didn't make it to Bible study, we had an author visit us. His name was Brother Owens, Reverend Owens, and Brother William Owens. He'll be back, I'm sure. He had to go to New York to be with his daughter, who is graduating. He'll be back in Sacramento doing some work, but He wrote a play called Bastards in the Pulpit. He wrote a book called Bastards in the Pulpit. And as I began to read the book, I realized that everything we've been preaching and teaching here, a call to holiness in the church of God, a call to righteousness in the church of God, beginning with the pastors in the pulpits and the people in the pews, we don't have to worry about the world. We don't need to worry about men marrying men or women marrying women. We don't need to worry about women giving abortions. We don't need to worry about any of that. What we need to worry about that is that God's people will be holy. that God's people will answer the call of repentance that the Holy Spirit is calling us to. We got to worry about holiness in the household of faith, because judgment starts in the house of God. And every one of us needs to examine ourselves and listen to the willing of the Holy Spirit. And when he says repent, we need to say yes, yes, yes. We need to repent with godly sorrow. Yes. We need to get up empowered by the Holy Ghost. We need to go forward, righteous and holy. Can I get an amen? Amen. I'm not preaching today, but that's free. Let me tell you something else. I go to lunch with Brother Owens the next day. William Owens is his name. And I go to lunch with him the next day. And I said, have you written any other books? I thought he may have written the one that some of us read called Loyalty. He said, are they political books? I said, no, it was called Loyalty. He said, no, that wasn't me. I said, but what did you talk about political books? He said, well, I wrote one about President Obama. I asked him about that, and he told me. And I said, do you know Dr. Alveda Keene? And he says, you haven't looked at all my books yet that you bought, did you? I said, no, I didn't look at them all. He said, well, Dr. Alveda Keene wrote the foreword to my books. I'm a very good friend of mine, you know, of hers. And I said, oh, praise God. I said, I met her at the NRB, the National Religious Broadcasting Network, in 2005, and we became very close friends. I said, and the gentleman I met her with, his name was Owens, too. And he was the first man that ever flew me across the country to come speak to people. He, on his dime, he flew me to Kansas City, Kansas, to talk to leaders. And I went there with leaders from Focus on the Family, and we talked to all the pastors in Kansas City, Kansas, and Kansas City, Missouri, about fellowship and reconciliation. And there should be no white church, and there should be no black church, there should be no Chinese church. There should be one church, the church of God, the church of Jesus Christ. And he got really excited, and he said, is this the man that you saw there, that had you there? And it was a picture of the Reverend Owens I knew, and I said, yes. And Owens is a common name. He shrinks a picture down, and it was a picture of him with his arm around the man, and he says, that's my dad. That's my dad. And God just sent him right in here, not knowing who I was, or that I had worked with his father, or anything, and that I was a good friend. So God's doing something. God's doing something. And of all the churches in Sacramento, why would he come here on Wednesday for Bible study? He saw Pastor Johnny and got invited. Pastor Johnny was doing his part. Are you doing yours? Are you inviting people to church?
Amen.
That's why we print this materials up. I mean, I love you all, but I don't need to print 1,000 shiny postcards for you. I can put it in the bulletin. We're supposed to be inviting people so they can come and hear the good news or take part in what God is doing. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. I just wanted to share those couple things with you, but I want to go and worship the Lord some more. So let's ask our worship team to come back and let's go before his throne.
Hallelujah. Let us stand to our feet this morning. We're preparing ourselves to worship the Lord. Amen. Worship the Lord because it's within your heart. But this morning is a special morning. We do not only honor our mothers, but we honor the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
With this favorite song of ours, we ask you and we invite you to worship with us this morning and give God the glory, the honor, the praise that He alone deserves for the special mothers that we have in our lives.
Hallelujah.
Raise your hands. Raise your voices to the Lord, for He hears you this morning. And He knows what's within your heart this morning. May you be blessed, and may God bless our congregation. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Adore you, oh Father. Keep some music going.
cross. Can you imagine what a supreme sacrifice? Not only the physical anguish that Yeshua went through. And he did this for you. And as he was laying there dying, as he was hanging there dying, he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. The God of all creation, Yeshua, the Lamb of God, Yeshua, the Word of God, Yeshua, in whom and by whom all things, including us, our flesh, were made. The God of all creation, the one that spoke us into existence, went to Calvary's Hill, and he died so you can be reconciled to him. I don't know if you have the gravity of what took place there. It's become such a portrait of church tradition. But it wasn't just tradition. It was an epic moment in all of creation. And he also said, by his stripes we are healed. He said, greater works than these shall you do. When I go away, I'm going to send a comforter who will teach you all things. The sick will be healed. Your sons and your daughters, they shall prophesy. I'm the part of my spirit on all flesh. He said the latter rain is going to be greater than the former rain. The latter house is going to be greater than the former house. So today, if you have a need, I'm going to ask our ministry team to come, our prayer team. And we're going to continue worshiping him. The word said the shout of the king is among you. Jesus said, be healed, you're healed. The woman came to him, Jesus says, if you are willing, Jesus said, I'm willing. He's willing, he did it. He went to the cross. So if you have a need today, physical need, financial need, spiritual need, I want you to come and agree at the altar with one of the elders of the church. If you need to repent, you don't have to wait to the end of the service for an altar call. You don't have to pray.
every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me. Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have Oh,
He loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves. He loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves. He loves us. 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 Hallelujah. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Oh, you're worthy of all praise. You're worthy to be adored. You're worthy, Lord. He's worthy. He's worthy. He is the Lamb of God. He's the light in the dark world. He's the rock on which we stand. He is mighty and he is holy. He is wonderful, the Lord, the lily of the valley. He's a bright morning star, the bright and morning star. He loves us just where we are. He desires for us to draw close to his heart. He desires for us to listen to his words. His plans for you are great. His purposes you do not understand. He has more for you.
With all. Decided that she was going to start faithfully tithing again. Within a few days, she had a call from her pastor asking her to go on a church prayer retreat with all the expenses paid by the church. The next day, she went to her bank to get some money, and the bank teller told her, "Don't withdraw any money. Since your 90th birthday is coming up, our bank is going to give you a present of $100 in cash." The following day, she got a letter from a community group to let her know she had been chosen to receive a $500 grant to help pay her utility bills. After she began tithing, she was amazed at the unexpected provisions she received from the Lord. Amen. You see, even though you're on a fixed income, or if you're not, God can do the impossible.
Yes, he can. Yes, he can.
Let's stand and let's pray. Hallelujah. Remember, God never changes. In other words, he never changes in rewarding us for being faithful to him. And we want to be faithful to him because we want to reach the lost out there. And that's the only way that God can reach is through all of our faith and tithing. Lord Jesus, I just pray right now that you will help us to remember that you're faithful. Yesterday, today, and forever, you are faithful to your servants and to your children. And Father, thank you for all of our mothers that are so faithful to you. Lord, I thank you for the example that they give us in how they give and how they have the faith to reach out into you. Father, thank you for them mentoring us in your giving, in your sharing, in your offering. Father, thank you right now in what you're about to do in each one of us. In Jesus' name, amen.
It's a shame to have an event not sold out. It was a shame that our Bible dinner was only 35 people and 69 people said they were going to come. So let's get the word out, okay? I don't know what the answer is besides prayer. We're doing our part getting the word out, but the devil's fighting, amen? He's alive and well in this community, but guess what? I got news for him. He's defeated already. He was defeated at the cross. And he is but a short time, so we've got to get busy, amen? Amen. Amen. We gotta get busy. We gotta get busy. So what you know, we're gonna put posters in the foyer. I want everyone to take one. Find somewhere this week to put it up, like on Monday or Tuesday. Yes. Put it in a gas station, put it in a grocery store. You know what? Risk a little bit. All I can do is tell you no, ask the grocery store manager, can I put this on your window? You know? When they start getting used to seeing our stuff out, maybe with the unctioning of the Holy Spirit, if we're praying, we're advertising, maybe they'll start coming. Amen? And when I say they, I mean the lost. Are we supposed to reach them?
Yes.
Are we supposed to reach them?
Yes.
What does the scripture say? It says, and the Lord added to the church daily as he saw fit. Don't you want him to see us fit? To add to our church daily?
Yes.
Amen. And so, let's do our part, he'll do his. Amen. All the ladies' faces right there in front of Sister Barbara, and we're going to give you a poster. Take it somewhere. I don't care if you just put it on your front door and invite your neighbors over to look at it. Put it somewhere. Ask people to come and call Barbara for tickets. So we want to. It's not about money. It's about souls. And Pastor Vera is awesome. I mean, that was the we lost money on a biblical dinner. We lost probably $800, but that doesn't matter because. God was, it's a ministry, we invested in it, and that's fine. We can invest in ministry, but when we invest in ministry, we want to get the harvest, amen? Would any farmer ever go out to a field and plow it and get it all ready and then not plant the seeds and expect a harvest at harvest time? Would any farmer go out and plow a field and plant the seeds, and then not water it all year, and cover it up so the rain couldn't get to it, and then expect the trees and the plants and the vines to grow, and to get a harvest at harvest time? No. So we, the church, are God's farmers, right? We're his fishermen. We're supposed to go catch it. Remember, fish don't generally just jump into the nets. Now, sometimes, when the Lord is in it, they do. Amen? Sometimes when the Lord is in it, remember he told them, cast your net on the other side, and if the net's filled up. So if we're casting the net, and we're listening to his voice, he'll help us fill our nets. Are you following me? If we're planting the seed, and we're watering it, he'll bring forth the harvest.
Yes, he will.
But we can't just plow the field. Or even some churches, some people, they just come to church at harvest time.
All right.
They didn't plant any seed. They didn't water it. They just came for the harvest. That doesn't work so well, does it? Kind of harvest you get. So, I'm encouraging you. I'm not rebuking you, okay? Pastor's not upset. I'm encouraging you, though. I know, for a few. But each of us has a mission. And there used to be an old saying, if each one reaches one. If we did that every year since I've been here, do the math. If we started with 17 people, because that's what it was down to once everybody finished leaving after my dad passed away, I ended up with 17 faithful. And if each one would have brought one the first year, we would have had about 34. And if each one would have brought one the next year, we would have had 68. And if each one would have brought one the next year, we would have had 136, right? If each one would have brought one the next year, we would have had how many? 272. Okay? Now, we've been slacking. And that's okay. God forgives us. But don't slack anymore. Go out, get one, and bring them to church this year. Amen? If we bring in a couple hundred, he'll bring in a couple thousand. And that's the way God does things, amen? He takes our little, and he makes it much. And it's not about numbers, but it's about souls. If you think about each person that comes into church, that didn't know Jesus, that comes here and meets Jesus, that's one less person in hell.
Amen.
And it's one more person to spend eternity with as a brother or a sister in Christ. It's precious. That's why the whole heavens rejoice. And there's no urgency today. He's coming. He's coming soon. He's going to come. And will he find you faithful when he comes? Ooh, Jesus is coming soon. We used to sing that. Jesus is coming soon. Maybe my Lord. Many will meet their doom. Trumpets will sound. All of the dead shall rise. There'll be a meeting in the skies. Lord, where no one ever dies. Heaven unbound. Right, remember that song? Jesus is coming soon. Morning or night or noon. Many will meet their doom. Trumpets will sound. All of the dead shall rise. There will be a meeting in the skies, go where no one ever dies, heaven unbound. Amen. I would encourage you that when you get to heaven, I want you guys to give me a run for my money. I want your to be bigger than mine. Amen? And brother, I told Barbara last week, I told her, I said, Ray was in the backyard making something you're going to see pretty soon. I said, to Barbara, I said, I'm going to have to hang out at Ray's mansion in heaven. It's going to be so big, we've got to fill it up. Because he's constantly working for the Lord and constantly doing things for the Lord. And so, you know, look at the beautiful trim he put on the sound booth and the things on the speakers and the black, he reposted our stuff. What's that? Fix the roof, you know, and he had help with Bill. Where's Bill? Did Bill leave? I ran Bill off with my screaming today. So, anyway, we need to be workers, amen? Yeah, I look at somebody that's in their 80s and they're still going strong for the Lord, like Mary Lou, like Ray, and it encourages me to get up and keep going, amen?
Amen.
I know it's not polite to discuss a lady's age, but we gave it away today. In the Mother's Day recognitions, and Mary Lou's in her 80s, and she's still going on for Jesus, amen? Going on for Jesus. We just got to keep going on for Jesus all the time, amen? Praise the Lord. Gloria, did you want to sing? Gloria has a song. Yes, we have time. We're expecting you, so come on. And let's welcome. You know what? Gloria has dual citizenship. What's that mean? She's got a church in Sacramento and she's got a church in Montana. So she's got dual citizenship. We don't revoke one because she has to live somewhere else. So welcome our longtime member, Gloria. God.
You know, some people think that the internet's a bad thing, but my mama told me that. She said, there's a song I heard and I want you to sing it. And she gave me a couple words. So I typed in a couple words and I found the soundtrack for it. And I ordered it 2 days ago and it came yesterday. So I haven't sang it before. So you guys just pray for me. It's for Mama anyway.
And I heard that Jesus I plead the blood of Jesus and his death. Of all. if anybody remember what that means, you know what I'm talking about.
Genesis 3:20, and Adam called his wife's name Eve, because she was the mother of all living. Matthew 12:45, then goeth he and taketh with himself seven other spirits, more wicked than himself, and they enter in and dwell there. And the last state of them, man is worse than the first. Even so shall it be also unto this wicked generation. While he yet talked to the people, behold, his mother and his brother stood without, desiring to speak with him. Then one said unto him, behold, thy mother and thy brethren stand without, desiring to speak with thee. But he answered and said unto him that told him, who is my mother and who are my brethren? And he stretched forth his hand toward his disciples and said, behold, my mother and my brethren. For whosoever shall do the will of my Father which is in heaven, the same is my brother and sister and my mother.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And we think about the beginning of our time, and we got to realize that the first mother of this world was Eve. And as time go on, Adam and Eve created and supplied the earth with sons and daughters. And after they were supplied as sons and daughters, then they began to increase. And as they increased, there became mothers to all generations. And we as peoples this day and time, we only think about the mother that we have and the mother that we did have. And when I say the mothers that we did have, mean the mothers that has gone on home to rest in peace. But we gotta realize, as we get older, regardless of the situation of the problem, you look at the elderly mothers. Look at Grandma Mary Lou. And look at this other mother sitting right here with the red wrap around. And if we really desire to say, and then Mother Hinkle up here, and at my age, I'll be 74 years old, but I consider Mother Hinkle as my mother, Grandma Mary Lou as my mother, and this mother wrapped in this red as my mother. And also, I look at Sister Young's mother, and I consider her as my mother. Mother Clucky, she's not here today, but I consider her as my mother. If my mother was still alive and living, September the 2nd of this year, she would be 92 years old. But I thank and praise God for the mothers that are here that we give honor and glory to. A lot of the generation, the younger generations, they don't think about the older mothers. All they think about is the mother of their own. But we got to realize God supplies all of our needs. So when your mother is gone on home, and I have a habit of claiming the other mothers as my mother also. And we fix it up like this. your son from another mother. You are my sister from another mother. And that way we consider the mothers that is here as ours as well, as they are your mothers, they are mine also.
So we got to
realize and put forth our hands. There's another mother sitting back there. Our daughter was here earlier and she's gone. But she, I claim her as my mother too. And this way we can realize that God has mothers still on this earth that we look up to. And when we get in trouble, the first thing we're going to go look for one of those mothers to ask these questions to try to get them right. And then if you get out of hand, the mothers see you get out of hand, they're quick to set you straight. And I don't mind being set straight by the mothers, because the mothers is above all of us, age-wise. God put them here for our purpose. Like he put all of us here for our purpose. Grandma Ethel, she ain't here. But with her age, she's the mother of the whole group in here. She's in her 90s, 92 or 93? 93. So that lets you know she's the top mother of the church. And being the top mother of the church, Mother Ethel will set you straight right quick and think nothing about it.
That's right.
And then on top of that, if you don't like it, she'll fuss at you right quick and set you straight. But mothers is one of the main things that we have to look up to. And we don't realize a lot of times that our mothers is our best friend while she is still here on the earth. We know that she's our mother, but she's our friend too. When your mother is gone, you wonder within yourself, why did you take her, Lord? But you think about it and says, well, mother done all she could do while she was here. And the Lord says, okay, you done finished your work, you done finished your job. Now it's time to come home. And when mother is gone home, you miss her. You miss your mother. And when you start missing her, sometimes when it gets to that point, you break down and you cry. And you moan and you groan. But when it boils down to the real nitty-gritty, God is your mother, he's your father. He's your sister and he's your brother. Your auntie, your uncle, your grandma, your grandpa, he's all of them. And we got to realize God is in charge. He gave Adam and Eve to begin the fertile of the earth, to multiply. And when they multiply, their children multiply. Their children after their children multiply. And when the world was destroyed, there was Moses, right?
Noah.
And his wife and his sons and their wives multiply. And that was the second beginning. We are the second beginning of the race from Adam and Eve, the second generation from Noah and his family,
we got to realize all these mothers has a reason and a season for being on this earth. We got to realize that they has a purpose for being here. I tell you, if you have a mother, she's still living, hang to that mother. Give all the love you can to that mother. Because, for one simple reason why, she's going to be there when nobody else will. She's going to help you when nobody else will. My mother's going on home, but she was the type of woman. She raised five of us by herself. And if you stepped out of line, she'd put you back in line. And a lot of you here got to meet her before she went on. But during that time, when I came to California, my brother-in-law and his buddies took me out the third night that I was here and stayed longer than I should. So when I got back to the house, I didn't want to hear Mama's mouth. She had a peach tree out in the backyard. I went out to the peach tree and got me a switch off of it. Yay long. And I walked back in the house and I said, "Here, Mom, I don't want to hear your mouth, but here is this, and here is this." That woman, she took five strikes. And after she hit the fifth time, she fell out laughing. She fell out laughing. She says, "You are very, very honored to go and get a switch," because she didn't want to hear me fussing at you. And she said, "But this let me know that I am your mother and I'm still in charge." And when your mother is around, respect her. If she get mad at you and fuss at you, says, "Yes, Mom. Yes, Mom. Uh-huh, Mom. Okay, Mom. I'll do it, Mom." And when she gets through, you go and do what she asks you, or get straight from what she told you to do, and walk the straight and narrow line. And their mother will always be there until she goes home. And a lot of people don't realize when your mother's gone home, she's still around. She's still around. My two sisters, Pearl and Danielle. Now, my sister Pearl has got great ways and actions of my mother. My baby sister went to a revival over at the church over on Winners. And I'm standing up in the podium, and I think the pastor was there also. And when the spirit hit, like it hit, my baby sister come from the back, shouted. And the shout she had was my mother's "Come on!" shout. And I got in amaze, and I just stood there and I just looked. And I said, "All right, Mama, have your way. Go ahead and shout and praise God." When you think they're gone, they ain't gone. They're still around. You might not see them actually face to face, But somebody in the family got your mother's ways and actions. So let us remember that mothers is going to be around until God say come home. Daughter just came back in. But hold your own love and kindness around your mother until she go home. And when she go home, she's still going to be around. When my mother went home, my sister, my brothers, they all of us came together. They fixed breakfast. And from that morning to this one, I'll never know where that breakfast went when they started rolling mother out the door. But keep your faith and your trust in God. Keep your mother as close to you as possible. Because she is, and she's going to be around till God says come home. Mothers is very important to us this day and time. Young men, young women, old men, old women. If your mother's still around, yes, stick to them, hang to them till God says come home. Hallelujah to Jesus. She is the mother of all until she go home to be with God. Praise the Lord. I am thinking about Mother Emma, Mother Hinkle's mother, and Pastor Elma. Both had the same type of surgery. Same type of surgery. And you think about it, when they was going through this, God was troubling the water. And they waded through that water, made it to dry ground. With their bodies still and their hearts still ticking. And it will be until God calls them home.
That's right.
Wait in the water, children, wait in the water, children, wait in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. I say, God's gonna trouble the water. I say, we in the water, children, we in the water, children, we in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. I say, God's gonna trouble the water. See that host all dressed in red. God's gonna trouble the water. Look like the hopes that boldly live. God's gonna trouble the water. I say, we in the water, children, we in the water, children, we in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. God's gonna trouble the water. See that hope's all dressed in white. God's gonna trouble the water. Lead a look like the Israelite. God's gonna trouble the water. Say we in the water, children. We in the water, children. We in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. Say God's gonna trouble the water. You don't believe I've been reading. God's gonna trouble the water. Follow me down to the Jordan stream. God's gonna trouble the water. Say we. Hallelujah, Jesus. God's going to trouble the water. And when it's troubling, you'll be able to wade through it and give him the honor, the glory, and the praise. Yes. All right now. All right now. Praise him, because God's going to trouble the water after a while. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's stand together and be dismissed. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise his Lord.
Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you now. We say thank you for the mothers. Thank you for your son that you sent through a mother. Thank you for your mothers and your brothers, those that labor among you, us, and do the will of the Father. Thank you, Lord, for giving us an opportunity to be workers together with you. Thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord, for encouraging us. Thank you, Lord, for all you do. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' name. And all God's people said,
amen. Amen.
Behold. Oh, Sister Jean wants to say something. Yes, Sister Jean. This is the last time Sister Jean thinks she'll be here a while.
I have a granddaughter. She has a little boy. He's 18 months old.
And she's not
wearing
my hair.
She gave birth.
Yeah, there you go. Thank you.
She gave birth last Sunday. Third great grandchild.
Praise God. Hallelujah. And we hope, Jean, that God doesn't let you stay gone away from our fellowship too long. He works out a way for you to be here on a consistent basis, whether it's once a month, once every 2 months, or whatever he decides. We're going to be praying for. I know, but maybe you'll get a Tesla with autopilot. Who knows? Sister Dawn, I really want to put you on the spot here in front of everybody, but I really see that you're going to be signing for us and signing for YouTube, so we're going to work that out. So we're going to find a way to get you here. That's your heart's desire and God's desire as well, okay? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's pray. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We already said it. Let's sing. Behold what manner of love the Father has given unto us. Behold what manner of love the Father has given unto us. That we should be called the sons of God. That we should be called the sons of God. And we are. Go with God today and be blessed.